Greetings of the day, children. I hope you all are doing very well. I hope you all have taken down all the question answers discussed in the previous session of the NCERT exercise for the chapter Air Around Us. So let us see what are we going to have in this virtual session of science. We are going to continue with the chapter Air Around Us, and we are going to see NCERT exemplar, that is multiple choice questions. And again, as you all know, the regular practice of writing multiple choice questions in your notebook. And how are you going to write? You all know the regular practice. You are just going to write the question and the correct answer. And for your future reference, please save the link somewhere so that you can revisit the video to recap, to reinforce concepts through MCQ solving. So please save the link for future use, for you to recap these concepts learned in the chapter Air Around Us. And please do write only question and the correct option number and the answer, so that you know the correct answer for the given question. So let us continue NCERT exemplar we are going to do today, multiple choice questions. First one over here, as you all know, we will have four options and we have to be logical enough to select the correct answer. Which of the following statements is incorrect? Now for that you need to be logical enough. You need to have a thorough revision of the concepts which you have learned in the previous sessions. You need to be thorough about the concept which we have reinforced in the previous session. So please go through the previous sessions and then you will understand how these MCQs are solved. Which of the following statement is incorrect? All living things require to breathe. Next one, we can feel air but we cannot see it. Next, moving air makes it possible to fly a kite. Next one, air is present everywhere but not in soil. You all have learned about the air, the various components of the air, different gases of the air, and how air is present, where it is present, how it is useful to all the living organism on the earth. So let us see the correct answer. By now you should have understood the question. So the correct answer is D. What the option was here, air is present everywhere but not in soil. That is incorrect. Why D is incorrect? Because air is present in the soil as also. You all know, you have learned in the previous session, all the living organism in the soil, they get air present in the soil and they breathe that air, the oxygen they breathe from the air which is present in the soil. So it is not like soil is porous in nature. Soil has fine pores, fine holes where air can occupy that space. So air is omnipresent. Let us see. Air is omnipresent, that is present every possible places, and it is also present in the soil. This can be proved by simple activity. There is a lump of dry soil is taken in a beaker or a glass. When water is added to the soil, it displaces the air, which is seen in the form of bubbles. So this is a clear explanation that air is present in the soil and soil is omnipresent. That's why the correct answer is option D, where it says soil air will not be present in the soil. That is incorrect. Question 2. Wind does not help in the movement of which of the following? First one, firki. Next, weathercock. Next, ceiling fan. The last one, sailing yacht. You all know the purpose of the air. You know, all know the role of the air. Let us see. The correct answer is C. Ceiling fan moves by electricity and hence wind does not help in the movement of ceiling fan. So if the ceiling fan, you are not supplying electricity and there is a strong wind blowing, then it will cause some movement in the ceiling fan, but it will not actually move the way it will move with the help of electricity. So here electrical energy is required for the ceiling fan to move and not the wind by itself. So next question 3, what is not true about air? It makes the windmill rotate. It helps in the movement of aeroplanes. Birds can fly due to presence of air. It has no role in water cycle. You have learned the various roles of the air and how it is very helpful for us in day-to-day life, and various natural phenomena, various natural process takes place with the help of air. So let us see, the correct option is D. Air plays a major role in water cycle. So air helps the water vapor to rise up to form clouds. Evaporation of water, cloud formation and falling of rain all takes place in the atmosphere. So the correct option is D, that is air has no role in water cycle, is not true. So please do write, please write the explanation also for your understanding. Question number 4. Mountaineers carry oxygen cylinders with them because you must have heard about the climbers of the mountain, the people who love to climb mountains, they are called mountaineers, and they carry oxygen cylinder with them. Why it is required? First option, there is no oxygen on high mountains. Next, there is deficiency of oxygen on mountains at high altitude. Next, oxygen is used for cooking. Next, oxygen keeps them warm at low temperature. So please guess the answer. I hope you all got the answer here. Very simple. Option B, that is, there is deficiency of oxygen on mountains at high altitude. So we all need oxygen, a good amount of oxygen to breathe and survive. That's why with increase in altitude, the atmosphere gets thinner and the supply of oxygen is reduced. This causes difficulty in breathing on hill stations and mountains. So when you go on hill stations which are situated at a very high altitude in a high mountainous region, then breathing becomes a problem. Therefore, on a higher mountain, a higher level, at a high altitude, climbers, they carry oxygen cylinder for the smooth breathing process. While climbing high mountains, mountaineers carry oxygen cylinders with them. Question number 5. Bujo took an empty plastic bottle, turned it upside down and dips his open mouth into a bucket filled with water. He then tilted the bottle slightly and made the following observation. So what Bujo did, an experiment, a simple experiment, and he made some observation. Let us see, we have 4 options. What is the correct observation he got? Let us see, you will make some guesses over here. You have to find some correct answer. You have already learned the concepts based on the chapter Air Around Us. All the concepts you have learned in the previous sessions. So let us go for the options. Here you have bubbles of air come out from the bottle. Next you have some water enter the bottle. Next one, nitrogen gas came out in the form of bubbles and oxygen got dissolved in water. No bubbles form, that is the last option. No bubbles form, only water entered the bottle. So I hope you all made some guesses over there and you got the correct answer. What is the correct option here? The correct option over here, which observation is or are correct? So it can be more than one observation correct. Here you have option A, that means there are 2 statements correct, the first and the second one, that is a solution. That means the correct option is A, and the A has 1 and 2, whereas B have 4th only, C have 3rd and 4th, where D has 1 only. So here it is said, first and the second statement correct, bubbles of air come out from the bottle and some water entered the bottle. That is the correct option which you have got, children. I hope first one and the second one is clear. So among the options A, B and C, A, B, C and D, you have A, that is the first and the second one. You can write down all the statement there in your answer, children. Please do write when you are writing in the form of question answers. So then you have question number 6. Which of the following components of air is present in the largest amount in the atmosphere? We have learned about the different composition of the air, various gases, dust, smoke, particles, dust particles present. We have learned all these concepts. So let us see which one of these present in the largest amount. Nitrogen, next option oxygen, next option water vapor, the last option carbon dioxide. As you all know, the option A should be correct. Very simple. You have learned about the percentage of various gases present in the air. We have learned the composition of the various gases in the air. So you have seen nitrogen, 78% is the largest amount of gas which is present in the air. Then next, 21% oxygen and the remaining 1% formed by carbon dioxide. Water vapor and few other gases also accounts to 1%. Thus, atmosphere contains nitrogen in the largest amount. This was very simple. Question number 7, the components of air which are harmful to living beings are. You have learned what all required by the living being and what is required for the respiration, for the breathing process. First option over here, nitrogen and carbon dioxide. Next, dust and water vapor. Next, dust and smoke. Next, smoke and water vapor. I hope you all got the right answer. You should make some guesswork here, children. The correct option is C. That is, here you have water vapor, nitrogen and carbon dioxide are useful to living beings. You all know that. Water vapor is important for the water cycle. Without water cycle, life will not exist. Will be very difficult to survive. Nitrogen is necessary for plants and carbon dioxide is essential for photosynthesis. So the option over here is C. The components of air which are harmful for living beings are dust and smoke. So that is your correct option C. And I hope the explanation is clear with you all. Question number 8. Usha took a lump of dry soil in a glass and added water to it till it was completely immersed. She observed bubbles coming out. The bubbles contain, first option water vapor, next only oxygen gas, next one air, and the last one none of this. So when you have seen this experiment, when you take a lump of dry soil in a glass and you add some water, you see some bubbles coming out. These bubbles will contain what you all know. The correct option is C, that is air. You all know the soil is porous in nature. It has tiny holes where air will exist, where air will find a space in that hole. So the option C is correct. When the water is poured on the lump of soil, it displaces the air trap in it, which is seen in the form of bubbles. So the air trap in it will be seen in the form of bubbles in water when you add water to the soil. This shows the presence of air in the soil. I hope this is very clear, children. And please do write all these in your notebook. I hope you are going to maintain your notebook and do question answers, MCQs in your notebook so that you will have some notes with you to revisit and recap and reinforce concepts. Here we come to an end of the session, children. I hope the session was interesting to you all, children. Please do keep your notebook updated. A gentle reminder to all of you. Thank you, children, and have a great day.